is God are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter to his gates with thanksgiving, to his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good and his mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth for all generations. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We bless his name today. Thank you for another privilege of coming together to worship, and we are so appreciative of your presence. We appreciate your prayers, your amen. We just want to glorify the Lord today. God's holy name, lift him up high and just represent him in a great and grand way. We want to lift up all those persons who are sick, those who are battling this COVID-19, all of those who are experiencing a time to come to the Lord and bless. He will bless if you will just let him in. We pray today that God will bless hearts and strengthen souls, and we ask that you would participate in worship. Worship is not a spectator sport. It's something you participate in. So we ask that you would participate in worship today and give God his due praise. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Scripture reading for today is found in Luke chapter 5, verse 7, Luke chapter 5, verse 27. We'll be reading verses 27 through 32. For those Gospels, we're going to Luke chapter 5, verse 27. You have to say amen.
Amen.
And after these things, he went forward and saw Philip and Levi sitting at the seat of custom, and he said to him, follow me. And Levi made him a great feast in his own house. And there was a great company of publicans and others that sat down with him.
But those scribes and the Pharisees against the disciples saying, why do we eat and drink with the publicans and sinners?
And Jesus answering said unto them, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick.
Thank you.
we thank you for our blessing that Jesus still loves us. We thank you for the future blessings. Lord, we just ask that you bless these kinds of offerings and be in any way to you. And we ask it all in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I'm
What kind of people do you want to spend time with. Sometimes people determine who they're going to hang out with by where they work, how much money they make, neighborhood they live in, you know, school, what they drive, all kinds of what their educational background may be. But that should not be the criteria that saints use to select their compadres. So your discernment spoke a lot. It's amazing how when Jesus picked people, he doesn't use any of that as his criteria.
Right. Yes, sir.
Look at the Bible. The Bible says that there was a man at customs named Levi. And Jesus said to him, follow me.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at that. Now, Mark says, and Luke says that he was a publican. He's a publican. In fact, Mark says, it's so much called a publican, he says he was at the customs table.
Yeah.
But it's interesting, when Matthew records it, Matthew says that they're calling Levi, he calls him Matthew.
Yeah,
yeah. You ought to know who he is, because that's him. You know. He calls him Matthew. He says he was at the custom table. He wasn't really ashamed of his occupation, but he said there was a man at the custom table. Y'all missed it. What I'm trying to get you to see, Jesus doesn't pick people on the basis of that title.
Hmm.
All Jesus was picking was a man.
Yeah.
Jesus doesn't pick ladies because of how they look. All he wants is a person.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't care what your background is. He doesn't care what your resume reads. He just picks a person. Oh, wow, that's powerful, y'all. That's powerful. That here our Lord calls this publican and says unto him, follow me.
Mm-hmm.
Follow me. Not doctor, follow me. Follow me. And he could have said, more than both, he could have said, well, he's a rich man. Because being a tax collector, homeboy made a lot of money. Yeah. He's in cahoots with the Roman officials. He is in cahoots with the government. And therefore, he can make some dollars. He can set his price. He had to pay a levy to the Roman government, and then he sets an amount over that to live off of. And depending on how greedy he is, how fair he is, he could set his price. He was a well-off man, but that's not what Jesus, he didn't choose a rich man, he just chose a man. Why am I belaboring this point? See, sometimes we ought to just appreciate people for being who they are. There's nothing wrong with church folk when you treat rich folk better than you treat poor people. There's something wrong with the people of God when you treat folk who are dressed a certain way, a certain way. And sometimes you come in not so nicely dressed, you got an attitude about it. It's amazing how folk fall over themselves trying to minister to folk who don't need ministering to.
Right.
We like to feed fat folks, but we don't feed folk who are hungry. I wish I had heard this. We like to give to those who already have. We like to give gifts to people we think might give us gifts in return. We like to help folk who we think may help us. And we have learned this whole concept of being a child of God is about what you can do for others in the name of the Lord. Well, look at this. The Bible says Jesus, when he gives, it's a recording of immediacy. That he says, follow me. And the Bible says, immediately, Levi follows him. I wish I had a witness here. Didn't preach no long sermon, didn't take a whole lot of transcript. He just says, follow me. And you're not going to realize he's asking him to leave a lucrative salary, a lucrative lifestyle, just to follow him. But the Bible says when he requested Matthew to follow him, Matthew gets up from the table and commit himself to the Lord.
Yes.
Oh, wow. I wish I had somebody here. that with Jesus, when he basically has a threefold goal. He saves a lost person, he gains a disciple, and then he also creates an opportunity whereby he can explain his ministry, follow me. And when Jesus says follow me, he's not talking about a part-time commitment, he's not talking about a temporary commitment, he's talking about a lifetime commitment. You've got to change your lifestyle in order to follow me. Oh, I wish I had it with this. But give Levi some credit. He understands. They don't believe that. They say that money is not everything. You see, you aren't going to find out what riches really is until you find out there are some things money can't buy.
Yeah. Say it.
I don't care how much money you have. If you die of cancer, money ain't going to get you out of that. It might get you some superior treatment. You might can go to some finer hospitals. But in the final analysis, you got to call on the name of the Lord. The coronavirus, as the coronavirus gets something that a lot of us do. See, a lot of folks who didn't believe in faith has to start believing in faith now. Because you can't tell out of something that thought to solve the problem. Don't solve the problem. I believe in science. I believe the ability of science. But you better believe science alone will not solve this problem. About being snobbish, you think you got it. And they, I talked talked about before, that separated. They separated themselves from certain folk. And so they have questions with Jesus' disciples. He's supposed to be all that. Why is he spending so much time with publicans and sinners? Why is he spending so much time with folk like that? Why is he spending time with folk who drink beer? Why is he spending time with folk? With people like that.
Yes, sir.
And think about this. Isn't it amazing that seemingly Levi knew better the kind of folk Jesus hung out with than some of his disciples did? That church folk seemingly have a problem with being associated with a certain kind of person.
I want to
say it.
We don't want to be unless two agree. How can they walk together? How can they walk together except they agree? Well, because folk don't agree with you initially, don't mean you can't bring about an agreement. You see, the problem with us, like I said earlier, we too busy seeing what's not there.
Say it.
Yeah.
If you got to be it before I see it, I'm not really walking by faith. I should be able to look at a prostitute and see a mission president. See a drug addict and see a preacher. I should be able to see not what I see, but see what I see once God has gotten through them. Not see who they are, but see who they can become. Think about it. Levi is so excited when Jesus calls him that he throws a party. Wow. See, when I understand what being a true child of God is, it causes me to want to. When I understand what being a child of God is, it causes me to want to share with others what has happened to me. Y'all missed it. You can't say you really love the Lord and love the things that God has done in your life and not be thankful. And if you're really thankful and you know somebody don't have what you have, you want to share what you have with.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And we got some folks so busy trying to be better than somebody, they don't want to help somebody be better.
Come over, because I think my Jesus is present.
head, I got to share. If I experience the joy of the Lord, I need to have it. You know, with this coronavirus and all of what we experience, folks say we need to get back to the norm. I can't wait till we get back to the norm. Have you ever thought about, and I heard a fellow talk this morning, have you ever thought about what we call the norm is not really the norm? What we call normal, maybe not all that normal. That is it really normal to care more about soccer practice than it is the Lord? Is it really normal to care more about earthly stuff than we start having to reorganize our priorities and things we thought were so important aren't that important anymore? Now we learn how to appreciate the simple things, just being able to come to church like they said. I was glad when they said, see, some of y'all been taken for granted, just being able to come in the presence of the Lord. Isn't it amazing how Corona makes a difference that I've been locked up and stuck in, and now that I can appreciate what God has been doing in my life, and maybe what used to be normal ain't really all that normal. You see, Israel got so caught up in normality, they wanted to go back to Egypt. We were better off in Egypt than we are dying in the wilderness. The problem is, you're so busy looking back, you can't see that God is trying to take you. God is trying to get you to the promised land, but you're too busy being enslaved by the devil. You ought to tell the devil, let me go, let me loose. I don't need you to enslave me. I want to be liberated in the life of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. And the perfect partnering physician. Yes. The Bible said that Matthew invited him to his house.
Yes, sir.
And he had a party.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he invited some friends of his. And the Bible said Jesus was there. And he was there, the Pharisees and the scribes.
Yes, Lord.
Keeping the law, they had a problem with it. They found fault and who he was hanging out with. Do I have a witness here?
Yes, Lord.
Jesus was asked the question, why are you hanging out with sinners and publicans? Yes, Jesus didn't disagree with them, but they were indeed sinners. Jesus never tried to call a spade what it is. But he understood the Pharisees had a problem. You see, when they called them sinners, their assumption was that the Pharisees weren't sinners themselves. Scribes, people of the law, but they felt like we can find your sins in the Word, but they didn't see their own sins in the Word.
Yes, Lord.
Now, keep hearing me repeat over and over, anybody who don't know their sin is somebody who don't read the Bible. Because if you read the Word, you're going to see that somewhere in there you're falling short of what God expects you to be. Pharisees had a category for tax collectors. They put them in a category with murderers and robbers. Said murderers and robbers and tax collectors were barred from the synagogue. It is amazing how they don't want certain people to come to church. Some people are so low down, you won't let them come in. I'm reminded when I heard T.J. say a while back when Oprah was interviewing, I told you that before, and she thought she had it, and she said, I understand you don't allow gay people in your church. Jay said, no, that's not true. We allow anybody to come to our church. He said, well, I understand that you think that being a gay is sin. And he said, I didn't say they were sinning. The Bible said they were sinning. At the end of the day, I can't make that kind of determination. God has been. And since I believe in the Lord and I believe in the Word of the Lord, I have to hold what God has said in His Word. Do I have a witness here? But because they are sinners doesn't mean that I don't want them to come to my church. because they're sinners doesn't mean that I don't love them. And when you're a child of God, you got to love everybody. And when you open up the doors, you have to invite everybody to come in. So you have to be careful trying to pick on one sin, because you see, when you pick on one, you might leave out of another. And the truth of the matter is, all of us have something that we don't want to talk about in church. Do I have a witness here? The Bible says they had a problem. Yes, Jesus said, yes, they are patients, but Jesus said, I'm a physician. In other words, I'm a doctor. He's not only a doctor of theology, but he's a medical doctor who can heal all manner of disease. He said, I'm not the kind of doctor that takes rich folks' money when they're not sick in the first place. These folk are sick and they do need a physician. I don't help folk who don't need help. I go to folk who need the help the most. And if you're sick, I can do something for you. If you have something wrong with you, I can solve your ailment. If something is wrong with you, I'm the perfect physician for you. I have a solution for sin. I can pardon your sins. Though they be as scarlet, I can make them white as snow. Do I have a witness here? Well, my brothers and sisters, and I'll take my seat after this, once we are willing to admit what's wrong with us, Jesus says, I can make it right. You're trying to pretend that you don't have a problem instead of confessing your sins before the Lord. And if you confess them, he said, I can live. Yes, drug is an addiction, and yes, drugs can pull you down, but it doesn't have to pull you down. I got too many testimonies right here in our church that'll tell you the Holy Ghost can get a hold of you, and he can take all of that away from you. That when God says he heals, he doesn't just heal some things. He can heal anything. He can heal corona. He can heal AIDS. He can heal cancer. He can heal whatever is wrong with you. The Lord knows how to fix it. So Jesus came to say, I am a doctor who can heal all manner of disease. I'm going to hang out with the sick folk because when I leave the sick folk, I leave better than I found them. When I leave the sick folk, they know how I feel about them. They know that I love them and I care about them. They know I want to save them. They know I'm not coming to gossip on them, but I'm coming to elevate them. I heal them. I bring them to the hell of hospital. Heal them of the disease. And then I pay a bill so they don't have to pay a dime. Is there
to walk in my finger. Is there anybody here?
I'm determined to reach my goal. hear that knock on the door. Because he's knocking on the door of your heart right now. You just open the door and let him come in. He'll come into your life and make your life better. God has no respect of person. And just like he uses me and like he used, you hear him, see him using others, God wants to use you the same way. pray for all those persons on our sick list and all those persons who are also in need of prayer. There's so much going on. Like 7-year-old kinfolk, the child got shot in the head. So much going on. We just need to be constantly in prayer, seeking God's guidance and God's help. She's in critical condition, but God is still there. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. God is blessing us. We've got so much to be thankful for. Thank God for the privilege of prayer. Thank him for being our refuge and our strength. I'm going to ask the Reverend Easton to lead us to the throne, but as he prays out with that, inwardly we pray with him. You know somebody you will ask to pray for. You can intercede for them right now. You know somebody who need prayer. They didn't ask for it, but they need it. You can intercede for them right now. Ask God to touch, ask God. But somebody needs salvation, but they're too hard-hearted to come to the Lord. But we don't have to give up. He said, if you keep knocking, the door will. Just keep on calling on the Lord's name. Come on, Reverend.
Sovereign God, awesome God, you are God's love amazing, Father God. Father God, we ask you today, Father God, we pray for healing right now for that person that got shot in the head, Father God. We ask you to touch them in this life, Father God. Touch from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, Father God. And Lord, if you be honest, all of us are sitting in need of prayer, Father God. Touch each and every one of us today, Father God. Oh, Father God, we thank you for this powerful service that has been with us right now. We thank you for the preached word, Father God. And we ask you, Lord, to help us to leave better than we came, Father God. We thank you for our pastor, Father God. Continue to strengthen him, Lord. God, in the direction of where you want this church to go, Father God. We ask you for Bethany right now to enlarge this church for it right now, Father God. Let Bethany be the church that you want it to be, Father God. Oh, we thank you. Father God, we know that you are the source of our life. You are the strength of us, Father God. Keep strengthening us. Keep ordering ourselves, Father God. We thank you just for being who you are. You're awesome and you're sovereign. There's nothing to compare to you, Father God. We pray for this world right now. We pray for what's going on at the White House right now. We pray for that president right now, Father God. Oh, Father God, we ask you to have your way. Have your way, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Pray for every person here today, individually. We pray for every home represented here.